All right, folks, this has been a long time in coming. I showed you this barrel, 18 months ago or something, and showed you its cousin back there, or its brother. But what I'm doing is this is a rain catchment system, and this is, at least to me, a relatively new device. I think it's Catch a Raindrop Rain Colander. Basically, you split your gutter in half. You insert the rain colander in the middle. It has a filter inside, just a debris filter. And then it catches the water that comes down on the interior of the gutter. And then shunts that water off into the rain barrel. I just got it done, so you can see nothing in there, but we're starting to get into the rainy season, so I have a rain gauge set up, and I'm gonna see how many gallons I get based on how many inches of rain we get. I know it's not gonna be as good as a full gutter catch, because a lot of the rain's going to go down the inside of that colander. But what I like about it is that colander does a filter. All the big debris is going to be just flushed out like normal, and it's just going to capture already pretty much filtered water. Not filtered for, sterile, but filtered of most debris. Up here up top, inside the gutter, I have a filter that catches most of the big leaves and everything that washes off the roof. Sorry about the panning here. Then you can see here, I have a little piece of fiberglass screening to keep mosquitoes out and any minor debris that might come down. And then I have some fiberglass screening on the overflow. So that it will also keep the mosquitoes out. Down there we have a spigot. Right there we have a skippy. So anyway, we're going to give this a shot. See how it goes. Thanks for watching. All right, thanks once again for joining me. This is an update. This is a video in two parts. I showed you the barrel was empty, but last night we got a little bit of rain. Wasn't even enough to register on the rain gauge. And you can see it's not quite enough to get the water up to the spigot level. But it actually worked. It caught the rain. And again, that's probably 2 gallons of water in the barrel, and not enough rain to measure on the rain gauge. So I'm pretty pleased with that, actually, because it means that it actually is siphoning off the water from the edge of the gutter, even when we don't get a whole lot of moisture. I was worried that the rain was going to have to come down pretty hard in order for us to catch anything, but looks like it's actually going to work. Now, this is an old, I'm thinking it's a jalapeno barrel that I was able to get at a local store. Everybody on the internet says, oh, just go to your bakeries, go to this, go to there. They're giving these things away. I haven't been able to find that in my town. Nobody's giving anything around here away. So I purchased this. It does still smell a little bit like jalapenos. Sorry for all the dog noise. But as it fills up, this is mostly going to be used for watering the garden and that kind of thing. So I'm not too worried about the smell. But now that the dogs are really going off, I think I'm going to end this. So you guys take care. Thanks for watching. All right, folks, one last update here. You can see on my rain gauge, I got just less than an inch of rain. And so now we're going to go over to the bucket. We're having a lot of stuff that we're doing on the back porch, getting ready for Halloween. So sorry about the mess there, but we'll come over here to the rain bucket. And
Look at that. That's full of water. We have about a 47, I think. This thing came in liters. So I think it comes out to 47 gallons. And on less than 1 inch of rain, we got us a full bucket. The overflow was working fine. You can kind of see where it's dribbling down the wall. No leaks. Screen's working. Yeah, it's a little cloudy. It's not beautiful, clean, clear water. Most of the time we're going to be using this. Most of the time we're going to be using this for gardening. So it doesn't have to be the most beautiful. Look at that. But I have a Katadyn filter. If I absolutely need to use it for drinking water, I can filter it out and then boil it. So there you go. This little guy's pretty impressive to me. It's a Catch a Raindrop rain colander. Again, I got it at Home Depot for about $7-$8. And it was really, really easy to install. And it really, really works. Just lets the water come straight through and scoops it off the sides. All right, folks. Well, I hope that encourages some of you to get out there and do it yourself. It, grand total, since I didn't have the tools necessary to do it right initially, it took me about 3 hours to do this project. My next one, now that I have all the tools, will probably take less than an hour. So if you got a little tool shop, you're probably good to go. All right, folks. Till next time, thank you for joining us.